96.7 FM, WORX. Good morning, and thank you for tuning in. It is 9.05 a.m. on this last Tuesday in the month of September. The last Tuesday means it's once again time for Cop Talk. I'm AJ Brammer here in studio, and I'm joined, as always, by Jefferson County Sheriff's Department Chief Deputy Josh Taylor and the City of Madison Police Department Chief John Wall. So, Chief Deputy, as always, good to see you guys this month.
Good to see you, AJ. Thanks for having us.
Good morning. Thank you for tuning in today.
And so, as we say, you know, like we said, always appreciate the opportunity to, you know, catch up and see what's going on with our area law enforcement. So, we'll start with the Chief. Chief, what's new at the Madison Police Department?
Yeah, this last month has been a busy month for the PD. Oh, mic's not working, right?
Yeah,
got me now.
Gonna do a quick mic change. Yeah, there we go. We're good now, John. Thank you.
Some people may say I'm loud enough. I don't need an active mic, but no, we've been busy. It's been a good month, so to speak, for the PD. We did a Operation Predator Net. We actually arrested 16 individuals that came to Madison or were from the Jefferson County area to prey on our children. It was a successful operation, and we just wanted to get the message out, and I think we did, that Madison is not the place that you want to come and try to violate our kids, because we're going to stay active and we're going to keep after you. Quite often, and unfortunately in law enforcement, we react to crimes against our children after they've already happened, and we know from statistics, and they're horrible statistics, that tell us that sometimes these children live a life sentence because of somebody wanted to take advantage of them. So it felt good to be proactive. It felt good to get these people off the streets before they violated any other children. We don't know the past. We do on some, and we know they have been previous sexual predator as well. So it's good to get them off the streets and in jail where they belong. I think they were going to quickly figure out they came to the wrong city and county to do that. One, we got an active law enforcement community here that we're going to come after you. And two, I have a lot of faith in our court system and our prosecutor David Sutter and our courts and judges. So I think justice will be handed down, and we hopefully will put a stop to any future activity by these individuals, and hopefully put a stop to anybody that think they may want to come to Madison or Jefferson County to commit these crimes, because again, the only thing you'll be hooking up with is me and a set of handcuffs, and I'm sure that's probably neither what you expected. So we're coming after you. Stay out of here.
And I think it's something that you, Prosecutor Sutter, and Mayor Bob Courtney touched on at the press release announcing the initial round of the arrests, was that, you know, it's a scary thing to think about, but ultimately it is, in addition to getting these guys off the street, it is a teaching point for, you know, families, just to make sure that, you know, kids are being safe online.
Well, it absolutely is, and I always encourage the parents, you know, monitor what your kids are doing. Don't just give them a free pass to let them get online and not pay attention to what's going on. And quite often the children will say to their parents, well, don't you trust me? Yeah, we trust you, but we don't trust the people that you're speaking with. And unfortunately, these type of people are very good. These predators are very good at what they do in luring children in with gifts or just their wording. So, as parents, we got to stay on top of what our kids are doing on social media, because it can be devastating. It can be deadly. Some of the things that we recovered from some of these individuals that came to Madison after searching them, subsequent to the arrest, was frightening. You know, duct tape, all kinds of handcuffs, zip ties, rubber gloves, you know, drugs, different types of narcotics. It was just taken back by, you know, by what we found on these individuals. And you know, my fear was that some of them may not have been going home had it actually been a 14-year-old girl. So let that sink in and monitor what your kids are doing. Like I said, if they're ever victims of these crimes, it could be a life sentence for them, and we certainly don't want that to happen.
I know it. You know, some of the arrests came from, as you know, the perpetrator drove less than 5 miles to the meetup point. I know at least one of them came as far as Michigan, so it was definitely a widespread effort.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it? That, you know, they'll come from, like I said, less than 5 miles or from 5 hours away. And that just tells you right there how twisted they are in their minds to drive that far to come and take the innocence away from what they thought was a 14-year-old girl. It's very devastating and frightening. So again, it takes all of us. We're going to continue it. You know, the word's out there, but we continue to monitor social media. So if you know, you think about coming to this area, you might want to think twice, or really, you might want to think getting help for yourself, because we certainly don't want any children, whether they're ours or anybody's, to be violated by these individuals, by these selfish, sick people.
Certainly. Looking over at the Sheriff's Department, Chief Deputy Taylor, what's new at the Sheriff's Department?
I just want to touch on with what you and John had been speaking about.
Certainly.
It's amazing to go and be able to be proactive, because unfortunately, a lot of times we are being reactive to the crimes against children with that, but putting it out there, it also opened up the eyes to the general public here, because they had the sense of security or the thought of, oh, it won't happen here, won't happen in my area. And I know several of the public service announcements or information that we've been preaching and teaching to the children in the school system is, be careful also with the community outreach to parents. Hey, these are the apps, this is what's going on. And I know that a few of the parents that I've met with and talked to over the years, they did come and say, hey, this is actually happening in our community. After the roundup by Madison and the press release, they were like, this is actually happening here. And we were like, we just weren't out there preaching and giving these statements to you just to say it actually is happening everywhere. And unfortunately, it's happening here. But it's amazing that the proactive efforts have been taking place to help protect our community and also hopefully drive these individuals away from our community, but also they'll have their day in court where they'll pay for their crimes. So that
certainly
is great.
No, I know. I get the press releases obviously here at the radio station. I know Switzerland County has been really active in the last, I shouldn't say really active in the last little period here. Law enforcement's always checking into these things, always keeping an eye on things, but specifically targeting these efforts. I know Switzerland County has been very active recently, and it's, we talk about it all the time. Children are they're our greatest resource, so anything we can do to protect them, we're going to do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Other things new with the Sheriff's Office, we just hired 3 deputies recently. We've got 2 out in field training. One started this week, but Deputy Combs, Deputy Garner, and Deputy Webster. Deputy Webster comes to us with years of experience from Jennings County. He took a short break in law enforcement, and then he's like, hey, I really want to get back into it, and he's gone through our process, and he's out there. So we have 3 new deputies working. We have a 4th one that'll be starting next week, Daniel Stevens. So we're in the midst of, typically when Chief Wallace and I are here, we're always saying, hey, we got openings, we're hiring, if you want to start your career in law enforcement. This is a great thing for us to go and say, hey, we're almost at full staff, we got guys out getting trained, we got gals out getting trained, and we're ready to go and kick butt and keep the community safe.
Definitely talk about it all the time. Law enforcement's a rewarding career, but when you are at the full capacity or close to your full capacity, it allows these guys to be working on the street patrol and allows the detectives to focus on what they should be working on, and just having that team available, having more resources, obviously just matter of numbers, it gets more work done.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, and the chief's right. It does feel good to be fully staffed. We have one officer yet to go to the academy. That's Officer Nicole Midget. She'll go next month. But I just want to give a shout out to our citizens in this time in which we live in. I mean, law enforcement, face it, it's taking a heck of a beating right now. But we appreciate the support we get here locally. We haven't obviously seen any negativity toward us here locally, and the only thing we've really seen is a lot of positivity. A lot of people reaching out to us and letting us know they care, letting us know they have their back, or they have our back. And I can tell you, we really do appreciate that. So thanks to our community for supporting us. As we've always stated before, as we work together as one, and we're an unbeatable team, and we want to continue that here in Madison and Jefferson County.
Just as the efforts that Madison PD did, if you guys weren't at full staff, if you didn't have a full detective component, you would have been successful, but you were able to go and dedicate more resources, more time to doing that. So that's just a testimony for the citizens to understand, once we're fully staffed, once we're able to do everything, people are trained and we have capable individuals there, our law enforcement agencies in the area can go and move mountains and do amazing things.
Yeah, we hear a lot about defunding the police. Well, this is what funding the police looks like here in Madison and Jefferson County. When you have an administration such as I do with Mayor Bob Courtney and his staff supporting us, again, this is what a fully funded, supported by the administration, police department looks like. We're very proud of it.
John, as we roll into the month of October. Of course, we are looking into the month of November, the November 3rd general election coming up, and we certainly hope that everybody goes out, gets registered to vote. The deadline is coming up next Monday, but just a reminder to folks that when you are showing your pride for your candidates, there are some regulations here and there that you do need to follow.
Well, absolutely, and you hit it right on the head there. Yeah, get out, register, and vote. That's where you need to let your voice be heard in the ballot box. But unfortunately, we're having some issues here locally, and I'm sure probably nationally, where signs are being stolen out of people's yards. Everybody has that right to put their candidate sign in their yard and that full expectation of it being left alone so they can support their candidates. So, you know, if you are caught, that is an arrestable offense, and we will charge you. So allow other people to express their opinions without you coming and trying to take that away. Like I said, the place to voice your opinion the loudest is in the ballot box, and we certainly hope everybody does that.
No, certainly, and you know, I mean, at the end of the day, campaign signs are protected by First Amendment rights. So
absolutely, and we don't ever want to see that go away.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think also, you know, less of a problem, but you know, keep them out of the right of ways and things like that. Make sure they're not blocking people's views of traffic.
Yeah, great point. Yeah, keep them out of right of way. Keep them in your own property, and most certainly don't block any exits or entrances as far as view goes from the motoring public. So just keep all those in mind and view your, you know, put your viewpoints out there, and we should respect each other.
Certainly, and then Chief Deputy, as we work our way into the fall as well, it is also deer hunting season getting ready to kick off. So definitely want people to be safe and make, you know, enjoy the deer season, but do it safely.
Yeah. We've already noticed a few complaints of individuals out enjoying the fall weather, driving four-wheelers on private property that they don't own, or tearing up crops. We've received trail cam photos and just other information that way. So be mindful and respect no trespassing signs. The purple paint painted on trees, if you see that there, that means it's private property and there's no trespassing. Also, we'll, I know, and get increased calls, and Chief Wallace from his time at the Sheriff's Office will know at this time, we'll get reports of suspicious people, vehicles parked alongside of the road. Please continue to call those in, or if you see people walking out, but be mindful that it may be hunters using public property or having access to that area where they're parking.
Certainly. It is, strange times sometimes, but definitely I want people to be safe.
Absolutely. And think about when you're hunting, sometimes that best shot's the one you don't take. Make sure you identify your target. Make sure you know 110% what you're shooting at before you pull that trigger. Everybody enjoys, this is a big area for hunting, and we love our hunters. They really get out, and 99.9% of them appreciate the land and nature and take good care of it. But we want everybody to come home safe as well. So make sure your equipment's in good shape, and make sure you know what that target is you're shooting at before you pull that trigger.
I know we addressed it on our last show as we were starting the school year, but always think it's worth mentioning, you know, school bus safety and making sure you're stopping when that stop arm is out. Can't say enough about it. Again, keeping our kids safe, but that is when you see the stop arm come out, that means you stop too.
Yes. I do know that Southwestern's had several reports of bus arm violations, and they've been able to effectively investigate those with the cameras on the buses and our SROs have submitted traffic tickets for review at the prosecutor's office. In addition, we have had deputies out patrolling and following some of the school buses that are having repeated offenses and trying to catch individuals in progress or in the action of passing it illegally. And we have had traffic stops off of that and issued citations also. So we are trying to go and be again proactive and preventative by having deputies and officers out there patrolling around the school buses, just the same as instead of reacting to them.
I think that's something that I joked about the last time we talked about on the show, was the fact that, you know, it's amazing that technology has done what it is, and you know, you may not think that the camera on that bus is good enough to capture your car, but even the tiny cameras nowadays, you can get a pretty clear picture, and they're going to find you.
It's amazing. I mean, years ago, you could see a speck of dirt on Mars' surface. Finally, it's trickling down to our capabilities of cameras here and home surveillance security systems, Ring doorbells, and we're able to make things out at a good distance out of just off a little tiny peephole camera. It's amazing.
Certainly.
Yeah, absolutely. And also remember now that the leaves are starting to turn. They're going to start falling. They sometimes create an issue within themselves, traction-wise, and obviously our kids like to play with them, play in them, unfortunately, on the long side of the road. So we just discourage that from happening. But just be safe and remember our ever-changing conditions here in the Ohio Valley.
Chief Wallace, as we work our way towards the end of the program, is there anything else you want to hit on today?
I'll just thank everybody for tuning in. Well, again, we appreciate everybody's support here locally, and there's anything we can do, obviously, we're always there for you. We are public servants, and don't ever be afraid to reach out to us. One of our phone numbers that we encourage people to call if you suspect, again, drug activity in your neighborhood, because we haven't forgot about that. It's 812-265-2121. Again, it's 812-265-2121. Report drug activity to us. If it's nothing, so be it. But if it is something, that may be the tip that we need to be able to follow up on and take care of the problem. So please reach out to us. You can remain anonymous. It actually rings into my office, and I'll disseminate it out to who needs it. Again, if you want to remain anonymous, you can do so. But please give us that tip if you suspect any activity.
We say it time and time again on this show that, you know, the public is law enforcement's eyes and ears. And, you know, hopefully when they make that phone call in, it turns out to be nothing, but much rather respond to a false alarm than not respond to a serious issue.
Yeah, that's so true. We'd rather go and take the time and investigate something and find out it was innocent instead of never be in the loop about something that was heinous and just somebody being victimized by it and having to live that sentence of life that John had talked about. So if you see something, say something, report it, make it be known. If you don't feel something's being done, follow up and ask the questions. It may be in progress, may not put the information out there about it, but the simple fact is if you've reported it and you're interested in knowing the outcome, reach out and do a follow-up on it also.
Chief Deputy, as long as you have the microphone, anything else you'd like to add?
I'd just like to go and say if everybody would treat each other equally fair and nice, it'd make your day go a lot better. That's one of those right now. We see individuals reaching out, and the complaints are they don't like what somebody's viewpoint, but put yourself in somebody else's shoes. Take the time, reach out there, and make society better. Our community is pretty awesome about doing that, but 5 minutes on the national news, and you can see how that people are just butting heads and getting into it. So,
and the Reds are in the playoffs, and the Green Bay Packers are 3-0. So, I mean,
how much
better can it get, AJ?
Absolutely.
Life is good. But, no, thanks for having us. And, we do appreciate everybody's support.
Absolutely. Definitely appreciate you guys coming by. That is Madison Police Chief John Wallace and Jefferson County Sheriff's Department Chief Deputy Josh Taylor joining us once again for Cop Talk.
Looking for that special gift for your favorite outdoor enthusiast? Or for yourself? You'll find it here. DG Power Sports has all your outdoor sporting supplies and parts. We're located at 10390 Highway 421 North in Milton, Kentucky. We're just 2 miles from Madison, Indiana, and only a short distance from the Dirty Turtle Off-Road Park and Dakota Racetrack. We are open Tuesdays through Friday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., Saturdays, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. I am Darren Gross. Thank you for your support, and I look forward to seeing you.